Welcome to Blackout 5. Shuffle team. Big twist. You underestimated greatly. Most number ones ever. How long did it really take me? The part I love most. He's back. Make some noise for Kid Twist, everybody! Everybody on safety. I can load every gun with bullets and fire backwards. Hey, yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Blackout 5 Toronto. Make some motherfucking noise! I am your host, Organic Man. I want to thank all y'all for being out here today. It's definitely a celebration for everybody in the fucking venue. Of course, my co-host and my partner.
You did, Gully TK. I got to send a special shout out to New Era, Adam, Avi Rex for making it possible for all of us to wear these beautiful hats that we're wearing. So salute to them. Let's go.
All the way from London, England, rapper to my left, introduce yourself.
Yo, it's Shuffle T. Shout out Strange Clothing, and I just want to remind everyone that sometimes in his intros he introduces like an angle he's going to use, and so I'm just doing that now.
Representing Toronto, one of the forefathers of King of the Dot, former King of the Dot champion, make some motherfucking noise and introduce yourself.
Let's go.
Kid fucking Twist!
All right, we did the coin toss. It is our Shuffle T. Blackout, let's go.
Jesus Christ, he made it. Holy mackerel. About to show you how this fire works. Roman candle. It's about to get hard, core, frozen apple. Rays in the roof, solar panel. If you make it through by the skin of your teeth, then there'll be no enamel. If you flop, you'll turn up in the river. That's the poker channel. I'm dressed for war when I need to go to battle, like I was sponsored by BCO Apparel. Don't you hate it? Right, when the nerdy guys with wispy Jesus hair go from cracking jokes and anecdotes to giving evil stares. Then they leave because it doesn't work and they return for the fans that didn't even care. And then they have to... Oh, sorry, Kid Twist, I didn't see you there. Canada, you're welcome. You've got an international mastermind. Comes fully stocked with stamina, heart, and rhymes. The full thing. The full package with bars combined at just 0.01% of Cassidy's asking price. That is a bargain, right? Against Kid Twist. And he's so proud of starting the whole white nerdy battler thing. Like he's the Jesus Christ of us. Or Leonidas, the freedom fighters who've seen the light above. White guys in a black culture, you've reunited us. Maybe white people can finally have equal rights for once. No more do we need those special seats to ride the bus. So proud that you broke through. Go you. We deserve to be part of this. So true. Now, he did start the white nerdy battler thing. There's no debating it's true. And that's exactly why I'm here imposing hate on the dude, because when people think of me, they associate me with who I look similar with, so they literally think I'm a faux creation of you. But I went online recently, and a poll was taken to use. Most popular white, nerdy battlers. Your lowly name was removed. I knew it wasn't looking good when Sharona came into view. Then I scrolled down and 100 bullets has overtaken him too. And people compare our hair. Your hair is not enough. My hair is soft as fuck. Running your hands through it feels like popping suds in washing up. It's soft as fuck. Softer than cotton fluff. Softer than pocket fluff. Softer than cotton buds. Soft as a washroom rug, it's as soft as a chocolate sponge. Soft as a body scrub. Softer than Forrest Gump. Softer than Soul's caustic punch while wearing a boxing glove. It's soft as fuck. I mean, look at this lunatic, fruity bitch, thinks he can move his fingers through it quick and swoop his wrists, and suddenly we're all like, ooh, it's Twist! What shampoo is this? Ludicrous, you look stupid, kid. I'm glad that you had decided to lose the quiff, but it looks like you started with human shit. And so he retired from battle rap to focus on his book. That's really gay. You've been writing it for 5 years and probably still haven't managed to finish page. Mark Zuckerberg retired in his 20s because he made $1 million in a single day. You retired from battle rap because you ran out of things to say. What you did wasn't even retirement. Why would you pretend? What you did was go battling, I won't do it again. Unless, obviously, I want to do it again. In which case, probably, I'll just do it again. You can't retire from battling, it's a hobby. You see how benign that sounds? That's not the kind of thing that people take lying down. Swap it for any other hobby. He's in a club, some lady spirals round, and he's like, yeah, I used to do crossword puzzles, but I've retired now. Time!
Chapatilla! Round one, it's our kid Twist. Let's go!
You handsome motherfuckers. Whoever said to use those Jesus hair bars gave you good advice, honest. Because the only way you beat me is in a Kid Twist look-alike contest. All those lines about your hair, man, I want to do that and see how my hand would feel. That's more like the inside of a banana peel or the wrapper of a Happy Meal. And just because we're at the Queen Elizabeth, don't think this Brit scares me. That just means you'll die inside a royal like Prince Harry was miscarried. It's shuffle tea. Wax flavor, tiny balls, call him bubble tea. But his accent exaggerated novelty, so never call him subtlety. I'll make them reminisce over you. You're in trouble, T. You'd probably be a wife beater if you only had the muscle, T. He's the king of comedy, but only because I passed it down to him. So once I disembowel him, I'm taking back my crown again, and I can tell you how this ends. As the second battle in which we see you spit some bad bars and throw the towel in. Shuffle sucks. You only play the Joker card so you don't shuffle much. Plus, you're a motherfucking muggle blood from Hufflepuff. You think Shuffle's tough? He's nothing much. I'm more seasoned and skilled than you. The hardest part is that I have to look at me when I'm killing you. You want to hear some nerd shit? Yeah! This is such a mirror stage, I feel like Jacques Lacan. I'll still end this princess's whole world, call him Alderaan. Nerd shit, when I have daylight run up on your block and spawn to stomp the shit out you for showing up to Comic-Con without a costume on. You wanna hear some real life shit?
Yeah.
All right, all jokes aside. No, all jokes aside. 2005 was the year my life altered. I've never been through times darker. My mind's monsters were a cross of Clive Barkers and White Walkers. Honestly, I tried suicide. Death seemed like a nice offer, but if I'd known then that I'd go on to start an entire genre of battle rap, I would have fucking tried harder. Because I'm the one who taught these scrawny, white, awkward guys to rap. And I sincerely apologize for that. So if you think all these parody bars are depressing as shit, then blame my fourth round for Fresco, where I invented that shit. Look. I know a two-on-two would have been better to give the fans, but Canada already has a famous twin lesbian sister band. Wait, no, see, it's more like Full House and you're the Olsen twin team because it took two of you to fill my one role in the scene.
Time! Round two, it's our shuffle tee, let's go, Blacko!
Saying I stole your style? Don't take the piss, bruv. I clearly stole Pat Stay's style. Stop making things up. It's pretty obvious, right? Now, I'll be honest. I've got something a little secretive coming. Because I liked that first round, but I thought it seemed to miss something. See, people say you're my double twist, but I'll make this a double twist when I make this a doubles twist.
And you won't see the twist coming.
What?
Yo, but apparently this is the kind of beating Twist wanted.
Two for the price of one, he'll be needing his courage.
And I haven't exactly had the easiest running. Shoff couldn't get me a plane seat with his budget, had to sneak me in customs. Do you know? Yo! Do you know how fucking hard it was to breathe in his luggage? Man! I knew you needed my help. Mate, you sounded funny.
Well, what can I say? It wasn't the same without you, buddy.
Sup, Twist?
What's up, man?
Your voice is fucking annoying. Piercing and shrill because you're actually 10. He goes to the hormone clinic and asks for the Janice from Friends. Yo. It's the sonic equivalent of Cassidy's stress in that meme where his eyes are coming out of his head. Yo, and you look more like Shuffle than Shuffle. It's a tough decision. You look so much like Shuffle, you make Shuffle look like someone different. Of course I stepped in. What did you think? I'd leave my boy on the rocks with a twist like a popular drink?
No! We're both here to take him to the top of the brink and then we're dropping this bitch into a bottomless pit.
I bet his novel is shit.
His novel is shit. It makes that graffiti in the men's room on top of the sink comparatively read like it was Oliver Twist. I mean, you've been writing that thing for 5 years. What are you doing? Improving the punchline count? If you were to write a sixth of a page every singular day, you would be done by now.
I bet you turn into a fucking weirdo when you have writer's block. Properly awkward bloke. Type to watch porn. He's not even horny though, he just thinks the plot of the story's dope. And when every publisher rejects you, it'll be daytime TV and slobbing it bored at home, which makes sense. A kid that no one wants to deal with watching the Maury show.
Woo! But to be honest, you're just boring to write for, Twist. Hey. You're boring to write for, Twist.
Yeah.
We're not going to pretend.
We could barely pad out a full round to go to the end.
We even resorted to using the same rhymes over again.
And over.
And over.
And over again. Fucking Alex Larson. Fucking average Joe. Nothing to kill. You're so run of the mill, you're probably running a mill. There was a party this New Year's at his buddy called Will's with sluts and a grill and hundreds of pills. All his best friends were there getting drunk. It was ill, so he stayed home, had a quiet one and just chilled.
Kid Twist is so fucking dull and grey that if anyone offered him a couple drugs today, he'd keep eye contact, turn around and run the other way.
Plus, you use your battle intros to explain your angles before you spit them, bruv. Why? So the crowd will understand every shitty punchline? That's like Chris Rock starting a show like, "Before I begin this one, guys, please remember how black and white people differ sometimes." And you called yourself a legend in an interview. A legend, mate. How? Oh, yeah. I'm sure they're writing you into the school curriculums any day now.
Now, this next legend's slightly kind of undiscovered here. It's not King Arthur whose bravery could conjure up a tear, or Lancelot who left his enemies huddled up in fear. This person's a legend because he drunk a couple beers and decided to do a rap battle once a fucking year. Oh, and guess who he said was his favourite 2-on-2 and his top 5 on the card? Yeah, nice one, mate. You're not on ours. Putting us in your top 5? That's stupid. And another thing.
No. You know what? Thank you, Twist. No. No. When this event was being arranged, Twist sidled up to Gannick and tried the upper hand, like,
"Listen, Gannick, I'm not coming back."
"How did you get in my house,
Alex?" "I know you want me to try another match."
"Do I?" "To be honest, man, I'm not fussed with that."
No, Gannick, you won't wind me up with that.
"Aren't you doing that book? Don't you need to ride a couple
tricks?" I'm not returning. I'm not. Fine, I'm coming back."
"What?"
But if I do make my return, I would like 100 stacks."
"No."
"Fine, flights, a couple grand."
"No."
"Accommodation?"
"No."
"I'll spend the night at mum and dad's." But. But. I want to wear my stripy underpants.
"Well, obviously I can't stop you."
"Yes, negotiation tactics, I'm the fucking man." "Oh, one more proviso, title chain, kinda want it back."
"Out of the question."
"Fine, I understand."
"Surprise 2-on-1, we fucked him up with this shit, so there's only one thing left to say."
"Shut up, Kid Twist."
Time.
It's time. Let's go. Round 2, it's on Kid Twist, let's go.
Okay, well, first of all, you tried to diss my negotiation skills like they were shitty and suck, but I negotiated to get you both here, so you should be bigging them up. I know what you're thinking. They set Twist up. A handicap match, this will be the end of him. No, I set Marlo up, because I'm really here to steal his best friend from him. Adam, if we were best friends, I'd phone you up to Skype for hours. He stands you up, then you go home and have a cry in the shower. On your girl's birthday, I remind you to buy her flowers. He just reminds you of your depressing life without her, like when you double-teamed a chick. And he was needy and quite the downer, but if we double-teamed a chick, we would go all night and wow her. And compared to your threesome, our threesome had twice the power, because you just did the spit roast and we do the Eiffel Tower. Organic, you gonna jump in? Jump in, man. Come on, man. Jump in. Fuck. Rich, you gonna?
Fucking all day,
you wanna jump? You wanna? You gonna?
Let's do this shit. Hey, let's go, baby. Hey, you can hear me? I'm like, shuffle and twist. The fuck is that shit? Shuffle and twist sounds like a dance move that'll have this old man busting his hip, or a technique my wife uses when she's sucking my dick.
Yeah, it sounds dumber than shit. But now that you and Marlo came to try and help, it's Kid Twist featuring 3 dudes who'd be nameless by themselves. See, we're more English than you, because we know the perfect way to mix a tea.
First you take a tricky pea.
Then add some British teeth.
Turn gimmicky to infinity, and then you finish with a twist of
me, because we're both...
Get him, baby.
See, because we're both skinny physically, but stylistically, you're a mini-me. Mickey Mouse to Minnie Mouse. They took the same image and made a bitch of me.
And you, your hairline looks like an old dying willow tree. Your eyebrows are 2 millipedes and your beard is a little bit of silly string.
Your shirts are... Your shirts are always stretched out.
Who dresses you? Your frickin' schemes?
Your shoes are looking played out.
Who dresses you? Your similes?
But this battle has racist stereotypes put to shame. Proof that white people are the ones who all look the same.
But actually, you guys kind of look like, you guys look like two child stars who grew up and kind of made a rough transition.
Yeah, the one who avoided the pitfalls of fame and drug addiction.
And the one that didn't. Right?
Marlo, are you honestly okay?
Are you okay?
Are you okay? I mean, it's clear Shuffle used to take care of you. And now that he moved and ain't there with you, you eat ice cream in your boxers all day playing Sinead's Nothing Compares to You.
So eat a dick. Oh wait, you already did it, BOTB6, when DBD touched that Oreo to his penis that your team licked. I know. British people aren't street smart, but here's a street tip. Don't take free treats and crisps from a guy whose name has dirtbag as a prefix. Right?
Yeah, see? We brought up Oreos, because you did a battle to advertise them like a couple mugs, you fucking sellouts. We would have held out for double stuff.
At least.
Marlo is not a pedophile. Because you pronounce it pedophile, right? Correct me if not. Your comedy sets were a flop, but you're still on TV and sketches a lot.
And I just had a thought. Since your parents are from the Church of Latter-day Christ, it's ironic these skit comedians can't even get live on a Saturday night.
See, that's because right? They're throwbacks. That's because they're throwbacks to when Monty Python comedy was the rage. So we'll leave your parrot dead in his fucking cage, then silly walk on your fucking grave. You grew up on Little Britain, but Canada runs the skit tradition. Kids in the Hall are even better at dressing up as English women.
So boy, you so British. Why don't you go and play Quidditch? A pound of you, that's a dollar. A pound of me, that's a business. You visitors here while we live it. We paint the picture so vivid. You beg the world for acceptance, we just ask the judge for forgiveness.
That's the difference. Look, the WRC's We Were At You reenact, but faster and shittily. What'd you expect from some actors besides theatrics and mimicry? That's the difference. They're a parody.
They're epic rap battles of history.
And we've actually been in some of the most
epic rap battles in history.
Round three, it's on Shuffle T and Marlo. Let's go.
Oh, dude, fuck off. Fucking, yeah, the one who avoided drug addiction and the one who didn't. Fuck you, bitch. I have a metabolism. You have a metabolism. Yo, how the fuck is this fair?
Yeah, now it's a 2-2 all of a sudden after a 1-1 back in the first round. Who'd have thought that totally impromptu stunt just happened to work out? You really think we're bothered about Nameless? He's the kind of guy to rhyme serious and delirious. So if you think he's good, you are seriously delirious. Because damn, son, in the WRCs you were the whack one.
And now it's Kid Twist and Nameless. Ooh! What a great team! I would have never doubted them. Fuck are you gonna do? Give us 7 out of 10?
It's Nameless and Kid Twist, Canadian misfits, but you both can't compete with the way that it's scripted.
Terrible team. You can't write to the level of chemistry with pen for one round.
Our transcripts show how well we interchange this stuff round.
It goes T for Theo, A for Adam, T-A-T-A all the way the fuck down.
Till that shit starts reading like one of Big T's gun sounds.
No. So you called us out to do a doubles thing, but I didn't think you meant literally a doubles thing, you fucking pricks. Suck a dick. You look exactly the same with your fucking luscious, thick, black hair and your fucking beards with
stubble bits. Why are you saying that to me?
I don't know who the real Shuffle is!
Hey, do you remember when you came to England and dissed her mid-round and the big crowd totally died down? Your voice quivering and shivering as you pented up both of your eyebrows. You look so nervous in that clash, I thought you were going to cry out. I'm sorry, I'm just really emotional right now.
Now supposedly you guys are legends. Two of Canada's vets. So there's really no excuse if your angles are stretched. And I have it on good authority that if you don't rap at your best, Drake will personally stab you to death.
Canada bars!
Your free health... No! Say it again.
Canada bars!
Your free healthcare is slightly more expensive per annum than ours!
Canada bars!
Your national parks are so massive and vast, if you travelled by car, your family'd starve! Why do you get angry when you're having a laugh? Man, when Nameless tells a joke in a battle, he'll be pulling his face like it just hurts. You tried this funny yet aggressive approach against him, and he was just awkward and didn't work. Your head goes red and your veins pop out, and everyone's worried you'll split a nerve. What's he like with his kid? Hey, you want to hear a joke? Fucking knock knock, you little jerk! But hey, you're a fucking father now, dude. Congrats! Congrats! Yo! You must be a happy guy. So awesome! You're a goddamn dad, it's massive, right? And family life. That is nice. Sacrifice. Remember when you used to just jam and write with 20 cans a night and go on acid highs and vandalize traffic lights and play beer pong at the guys so you rap outside and fucking fuck random women with tanning lines and generally have a life? Now you won't have the time!
Paradise! Hey look, and he's only a newborn now, but that kid will become a right little fucker soon. Trust me. And you'll have to take that awful brat's crap. Come home to you, find your studies all destroyed and ransacked. You look into wallet and see he's taken all of that cash, but you still have to love him unconditionally, or you're a bad dad.
Nah, we're just kidding. Congratulations.
But fuck, your kid is ugly. Little freak of the night. Fuck, your kid is ugly. Little freak of the night. It looks like Chucky got hit with a meteorite. You're normal looking. So I blame your skis of a wife for making the ugliest fucking baby I've ever seen in my life.
Well done, congratulations. It's got fucked up red rashes and a gargoyle face with some sunken eyes. It looks like my shit when it's quite big and I failed to flush it twice. I got asked to rate how ugly it is on a scaling from 1 to 5 and said that's not enough. When I look at that fucking baby, I want to die.
It's a bundle of joy.
It's amazing.
You guys need to stop claiming the nerd squad. You'll never be as nerdy and awkward as us. These are the jocks in disguise as the unpopular guys. You're both perfectly normal to us. These are two confident go-getters using a certain performative touch against two guys who are literally too nervous to talk on a bus.
Want to know how we did in LA? Let me find the right words. We fit in Cali like Marv 1 would fit in. My shirt.
Lush took us to the hotel, but we had to wait till some of the rooms were cleared.
So for killing the time, he thought he'd take us up to the hood for beers.
We were shaky as fuck, thinking, Jesus, man, someone could shoot us here.
Until we finally left because Lush had a meeting discussing a few ideas.
We thought, well, he's doing that, we'll go around for a couple of souvenirs. Instead, we somehow end up in this meeting with Alki David and some of his junior steers. We've gone from the hood to a billionaire's office with Lush and his group of peers thinking, Jesus Christ, what in the name of fuck are we doing here?
This is real shit, you can ask Lush. We were driving around town, I was thinking, we are not a part that counts in this pattern. I had half a toke of a blunt and was nearly passing out like a faggot. Then we were in Alki's office, getting asked about and examined, like, hang on a sec, I come from fucking Berkshire, how did this happen? See, you are not nerds, because we are not as cool as anyone in this room.
Let's put that into perspective. Sharon is in this room.
Time.
Cheer, round three, it's on Kid Twist and Nameless, let's go.
See, after you dissed his kid, you had to keep saying nah, so we wouldn't mistake you for the coldest spitters. That's why you use parody gun bars, because in reality, you're scared to pull the trigger. And you guys might not get this because I'm about to reference some Brit TV, but we are Canadian misfits because we get superpowers from the crowd's electricity.
English bars. See, that's the thing. Because your bad bars are bad, bad bars. Because they're actually kind of rad. But then your good bars are bad, good bars. Because they're actually kind of bad. So it's just your timing that's bad.
You should get good at knowing your part. We've got bars that are good and bad.
At the same time.
We call them Schrodinger's bars.
Like, I'm like, it's like, I'm way too comfortable with the tool out. That's a handyman. I split a sweet potato for the syrup. That's a candy gam. I bring it to your desk when you're at work, like a candy gram, and pull out and start shooting when you least expect it. That's a candid cam.
Yo, I got something to push your wig back smooth. That's some Dapper Dan.
I pull strings to get you rocked for the cream, like it's Clapton's band.
These bitches feel it in their chest when I squeeze, that's a mammogram.
Boy, I let the llama blam like an anagram for Bamalam. Right? Or like that one.
See,
See,
we're street next to you. Because your battles are mandated to feel like mandates.
So thanks for your fan base, but you've just shown us your British shit just doesn't translate.
Because you haven't adopted the culture, you've co-opted.
You're tourists. It's so obvious you're window shopping. We're so opposite.
We're like a paradox.
That's the place where the deep thoughts exist.
They're like a paradox.
That's where Pops keeps his boats locked up at both cottages.
But you give that Common People song a sequel, because you act poor like it's loads of fun. You're like my rap partners. Used to be rich, now you're some random local bum.
The fuck? You didn't practice that one. What was that? It's okay. Hug life, baby.
I'm lonely, son.
Started from the upper class, now they're here.
Yeah.
In a flat so filthy, girls tell you they don't want to fucking here.
And this year I bought a house. And you're right, I had a son to continue the legacy. This year you got a couch off the side of the road so you can get some sleep.
Hey, remember when Wiz and Sizz beat you for the title of DF's cheesiest act and Marlo was the Jesus of rap? He carried a wooden tee on his back? But I bet you steal Shuffle's locks to rub on your baldest spots and pray to a hair shrine, because your aging hairline's plane disappeared like an Asian airline.
And me, I've never made a careful statement. Like when I came to your country and said that shit to her. I was prepared to take whatever people had to say to me. I stood there to face it. But much to my surprise, there was Nathan. And I'm paraphrasing, but you told me you agreed with me. You were just scared to say it. So you're that kid hiding in a basement while his parents fought, then snuck upstairs to tell Dad, I agree with you, but quietly, because you're scared of moms. Well, I'm that loudmouth getting kicked out of the class for trying the teacher. I said I'm that loudmouth getting kicked out of the league for trying to teach her. And that weekend, he was pretty pissed at me. But clearly the kid listened to me because he's at this event, isn't he?
I mean, you thought you'd bring a peace treaty in our league's beefing would end instantly, but white North Americans and peace treaties?
That's not such a great history.
Yes.
I haven't done that. Not going too well.
You always say you go together like shit, but you go together like...
Human Torch?
And Aquaman.
Designer nerds?
And Comic Sans.
Rioters?
And soccer stands. Even your poshest fans find your voice as soft and bland. You make a hook sung by Aubrey Graham?
Sound like a round from Hollow Hands. But I leave this hometown crowd smoked out like it's Hush's house. Dutch has got you feeling crippled, there's no crip walk, get your crutches out. Battle rap is at one moment they talk about that hushes crowds. Why you think it's KO, TD,
knockout,
it's that touchdown!
Yeah. What, you thought we fumble going up with Shuffle T and Marlo?
I'd be more afraid of a fist fight with Carter Deems and Bartone.
We love you, Carter Deems.
Bartone knows those cats.
Toronto, make some motherfucking noise!